Another major function of autophagy is in organelle homeostasis. Recently, there has been intense competition in the research of mitophagy, which refers to the selective autophagy of mitochondria. This is partly because it was reported that two proteins known to be implicated in Parkinson's disease, named PINK1 and Parkin, are directly involved in mitophagy. Mitochondria that have become dysfunctional can produce reactive oxygen species that damage other cellular components and cause cell death. PINK1 accumulates on damaged mitochondria next to recruiting Parkin, which marks these mitochondria for autophagic degradation by modifying proteins on the mitochondrial surface with ubiquitin. Now we know that not only mitochondria, but other organelles such as peroxisomes, lipid droplets, and damaged lysosomes are also selectively degraded by autophagy in yeast and mammals. These pathways are called pexophagy, lipophagy, lysophagy, respectively. Selective autophagy of organelles is currently a hot topic in autophagy research. In my lab, we recently discovered new pathways named nucleophagy and ERophagy in yeast, which selectively degrade part of the nucleus and the endoplasmic reticulum, commonly called the ER. This slide showed the basic mechanism of target recognition during a selective autophagy. Degradation targets are first recognized by binding proteins called autophagy receptors, and these proteins also bind to ATGH on nascent autophagosomal membranes, leading to efficient sequestration of the target into the autophagosome. In our work, we identified the previously unknown autophagy receptors ATG39 and ATG40. In response to starvation, ATG39 appears on the nuclear envelope and induces the sequestration of part of the nucleus into the autophagosome by binding to ATGH on the forming autophagosomal membrane. Under the same conditions, ATG40 appears on the ER and draws fragments of the ER into the autophagosome, also through its interaction with ATG8. The interesting thing is that these results were obtained using yeast, but at the same time as we reported our findings, a research group in Germany identified FAM134B as a receptor for ERophagy in mammals, which is known to be involved in a disease called sensory neuropathy. These results indicate that ERophagy is an important process existing in both yeast and humans, and again show how research in yeast can help inform our understanding of a disease in humans. The physiological roles of nucleophagy and ERophagy are still under investigation, and the identification of a counterpart for ATG39 in humans could potentially unveil a relationship between nucleophagy and additional diseases in humans. We have so far considered the roles of autophagy in yeast and mammals, but the function of autophagy in plant cells are also being explored extensively. For instance, when autophagy is blocked in thalocrasts, which is a commonly used model in plant research, it becomes sensitive to nutrient starvation, ages faster than normal plants, and becomes very sensitive to bacterial infection. Selective autophagy of peroxisomes and of chloroplasts in plant cells have also been reported. Thus, autophagy plays important roles in a wide range of physiological phenomena in plants, as well as humans and yeast.